Yes. Houston, we have power.
Nice work.
I couldn't have done it without you.
Come on, let's find something to block the door in. I don't want to have to come back up here every month to clean this shit out.
Wait, you're gonna be here in a month?
What? No, I don't know. Would you just... Jesus.
I'm just fucking with you, Deke. Come on. So, why'd you ask about my dad and my brothers?
I don't know. He just, you never mentioned him before, so, you know, I'm sorry if I... If it's something you didn't want to talk about.
Oh, that's fine. In fact, it reminded me.
Okay, Ricky, not now. You can ask me later. Come on, we gotta get moving. What did you drop?
Hey, you never asked why I stopped riding with you and Boozer.
Was I supposed to ask? I already knew why. Iron Mike's bullshit. God, Ricky, do we gotta do this now?
We had been riding together for, I don't remember, a couple months. Deacon, come on.
Okay.
There was this one night, and I remember it really clearly. It was snowing outside, and Boozer was snoring. You remember how he used to snore? I swear, I thought he was going to bring a horde down on us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, well, that pretty much hasn't changed.
Anyway, you thought everyone was asleep, and you were sitting outside by yourself like you always did, and you were staring at something. You didn't sleep the whole night. Let me see the photo, Deke. Come on, please. This is when I knew.
What'd you know, Ricky?
That I didn't want to end up like so many of us here. We're trapped in the past or running from it. I want to look forward. Okay? Not back.
This isn't what you think it is, okay?
Get low! Beyond the back! Find them!
Are you sure it's them?
I saw the mark on his back!
We're from Lost Lake Camp! Iron Mike has a treaty!
Hey. Well, that was a really good idea. You want to try that again?
Yes.
Stay put. Keep your head down.
Stop.
How long have you been a camper?
You assholes are kind of far from home, aren't you?
damn it. Listen to me. We're from Lost Lake. We have a tree.
Far north, aren't you? Huh? You don't want to get too far away from Carlos, do you? How about we just leave you here to bleed out, huh? Make all the freaks out here happy, yeah? Huh? Isn't that what you want? think that's the last of them. No idea. Back in the day, dealt with a few tweakers who acted like that. I think they're on PCP or whatever that other shit is.
Oh, bath salts. Remember? That was becoming a thing before everything went down.
Right, yeah. Come on, let's see if they messed up our bikes. Think that Iron Mike's treaty with these bastards is gonna hold?
I don't know.
Fucking rippers, after what they did to Boozer's arm, after what they did to Lisa, what?
This was clutched in one of their hands. What happened? Did you guys have a run-in, you and Boozer, with the rippers before you stole the antibiotics?
Well, I don't know. Look, whatever Carlos thinks I did, ain't gonna compare to what I'm gonna do to him if I ever see the son of a bitch.
Come on, let's go.
Okay, we have to follow the line south. Check the transformers. Make sure they're all good.
Okay, I'm following you. Did I stop you?
How'd you end up in the MC?
It's a long story.
We got a long ride.
Okay, I was a member of the 10th Mountain, part of a forward unit working with the Northern Alliance.
Shit, I didn't know you were in the Army. Why were
you? You want to hear this or not?
Sorry.
We were advancing on Mazar-e Sharif. We got ambushed by a group of Taliban heading the other way. And they were in flatbed trucks, decked out with ZU-23s, modified anti-aircraft guns.
Big guns.
Yeah, really big fucking guns. Our Humvee exploded, went over a cliff, right into the Hari. You know how hard it is to drown in Afghanistan? It's hard. The place is one giant goddamn desert. Anyway, I was thrown clear, and when I came to, the Humvee was upside down in the river. I swam out to see if anyone survived. I pulled a body back to shore, and I did that 7 more times. And by the time I pulled in Tanner, my Sarge, I was done. And when I came home, I don't know. I bought a bike, spent a couple of years on the road, just moving from place to place, and
to farewell? You grew up around here, right?
Yeah, always.
Yeah. Okay, so by the time I finally settled down, I got a job at a bike shop run by this old guy named Jack. And he ran the club. The press, that's what we used to call him. He patched me in himself.
Wait, Jack.
Some bad shit went down, and he ended up taking the rap for the club.
Sounds like you guys are pretty tight.
shit. There had to be one, right?
Let's come back in the morning. You can get whatever tools you need, and we'll finish it up then. There'll be fewer freaks out.
So no hot shower tonight? Okay, but I want to show you something first.
Oh, Ricky, it's been a long day.
Come on, you know a lot about the freaks. I just want to show you something you might not know. Come on, we're out here anyway.
Shit, okay.
Let's go.
Can I ask you...
God, like I said before, could I stop you?
Why are you still flying colors?
I don't know what you mean.
I mean, why do you still wear the cuts? You and Hoser, it's not like you're trying to recruit anymore or staking out territory.
Now?
A couple of guys I worked with at the plant wore colors on the weekend. I asked them about it once. They said they wore them as a way of saying, fuck you, to, I don't know, cops, authority, the government. So what are you rebelling against?
Whatever's left. Look, we wear them because we wear them. What do you want? I mean, no idea about Boozer, but I ain't trying to say shit. It's just, cut? That's who I am. Done a lot of stupid shit in my life, but joining the MC, well, let's just say that it's one of the few things that I don't regret. Ricky. What are we doing here? I've seen the Nero death trains before and hordes.
I know. Not like this.
What the fuck?
Watch. I've come out here a few times to see them. They stay in those old machine buildings and they come out every night like someone's ringing a dinner bell, right? When it's morning, they go back inside and what? Hibernate?
You mean you never went down there to see?
Aha. Uh-huh. No. One time I got way too close, and a dozen of them started chasing me. It's like poking a hornet's nest. Come on, let's get out of here. It's getting dark.
Hey, where the hell have you been all day?
Nice to see you, too.
Yeah, well, Schizo said you and Deacon took off, and I was worried.
Okay.
Oh, that's rich.
Hey, Deacon. Thank you.
Yeah, well, just let me know when you're ready to tackle that transformer. I'll be around.
Sure.
It's bullshit.
What is your problem?
No, no! What is your problem?
I just said I'm tired. That's it.
Okay, I'm sorry. Like I said, I was worried. It's not like you to just take off without talking to me.
Okay.
So that's it?
first one. How does it work? Day it turned out. Behind the counter is a small coffee
joint. That's a day I'll never get.
Warnings had gone out, but no one was.
Oh, hey, look at that. Too late for marsh duty. Yeah, it's too bad, huh? Schizo. Schizo. Speaking of schizo, I wonder what the hell.
Just one?
That's all I got today.
Hey, Ricky, you there? I'm gonna be gone for a while. I'm gonna need you to cover for me. Skiz is gonna wonder why I'm not out on marsh duty or whatever the hell.
Hey, Deke. What's up?
Boozer's, he's depressed or something. Talk to Addy. I think I know a way to cheer him up.
So what are you gonna do?
I thought I'd maybe head to O'Leary Mountain, get his bike.
Long way to go on foot.
Let's figure something out. Are you gonna cover for me or what?
Yeah.
Thanks, Ricky. Deacon out. Should be it.
Then come on. Yeah, run at him! Now you're gonna pay.
Deke, you tracked down those boys, shot up the gate, and took off?
Hey, Mike, yeah. I found them, and they won't be coming back.
Seems like it's getting worse. The amount of squatters and drifters we got coming through. No offense to present company.
Mike, it's getting worse. I don't know. Mike, I think it's like you were saying about tourists always coming up here from California. Well, I guess if I had the choice, yeah, I'd rather be here than down there.
Yeah, I guess so.
Good.
See you, Deke. Iron Mike out.
Boozer, are you there?
Yeah, Deke.
How you doing, brother?
Same as always. Still out there chasing choppers?
Yeah.
Figure out what the hell they're up to yet?
Not a clue. What O'Brien told me seems legit. Nero's out here, or they're running field missions, studying the freaks. No idea why.
Hey, I gotta get going. Schizo stopped by and said I'd be shoveling shit all day.
Tell Schizo to eat shit.
Yeah, I'll pass that along. Later.
Yeah. Deacon, can you stop by?
Oh, let me guess. You got a job for me. Yeah. Okay. St. John out.
Deke, this is Tucker. You out there?
Tuck, yeah, I'm here, and I'm guessing you got another job for me. So, okay, I'll stop by. Deacon out.
Slate Boozer says... I hear a bunk calling my name. That should do it.
I brought you something.
Wait, what the fuck? You went up and
cope getting it, parting it out.
Jesus, Deke.
Hey, I mean, I mostly did it, you know, in case I need parts. It's not like your gimp ass is gonna need them.
Shit. Thanks, brother. That's the one thing I miss. Riding on the open road.
Addie just wanted me to tell you that she paid some men to go get your bike and bring it back. It's over at the mechanic shop.
Oh, wait, what?
You're welcome, Deke. Ricky out.
Here for your bike?
Just looking for some stuff.
Gonna be here late.
Trying to make forever a day or two, will ya? This thing is completely broken.
It's me.
hell's my ratchet wrench?
I'm a busy guy, Deke.
Where the hell's my ratchet wrench? Never find anything.
Hello? Earth to Deacon?
Hey.
Get out of the way.
Later, Deke. You need something?
Hey, how's it going?
Deke, I'm really worried.
Ricky, what's up?
The Butler twins, Abigail and Gabby. You know them?
No, but I seen them around. What's going on? What's wrong?
They went out fishing yesterday, and they didn't come back.
Well, the lake shore is pretty safe so long as they stay out of the marsh.
That's just it. They weren't at Lost Lake. They went east, over to the Metolius River.
What the hell were they thinking? Okay, all right, yeah. I'll see if I can find them.
Deacon, thank you so much.
Hey, man.
Just looking around.
St. John, this is Mark Copeland at Deacon St. John.
Hey, Cope, what's up?
Yeah, run at
Let's
him.
Check it in. A couple of my men were up to the top of O'Leary Mountain the other day. Said they found a safe house set up in an old Forest Service watchtower.
Is that right?
Yes, sir, that's what I'm told. They said it was abandoned, but funny thing. Whoever lived there left behind a bike. Good shape, too, by the sound of it.
Really?
Indeed. That's not the funny thing. The funny thing is they went back up there today to pick it up, but the bike was...
Okay, what were you saying?
Indeed. That's not the funny thing. The funny thing is they went back up there today to pick it up, but the bike was gone. Now, ain't that a head-scratcher?
Look, Cope, this is all really fascinating, but,
Now, hold on. Here's the fascinating part. They swear that old bike, well, it looked a lot like the one Boozer used to ride.
Okay, so let me get this straight, Cope. You guys went up to O'Leary Mountain. You found what you thought was Boozer's bike. And the first thing you thought of was, hey, why don't we just go back and steal it?
Salvage, Deke. Salvage. But no, that was my second thought. My first was, whatever happened to old Boozer? Manny says he hasn't seen him around for some time.
I don't know, Cope. Next time I see him, I'll let him know how much you miss him. St. John out.
Murderers and thieves, the lot of you. How many people you killed today, huh?
Deacon, you there?
Yeah, Addie, what's up?
Can you stop by the infirmary when you get a chance?
Anything wrong?
No, I just need to talk to you.
Yeah, okay. Hey, Ricky, what else can you tell me?
Before everything went to hell, the girl's family had a fishing site that they always used to go to. I marked it on your map.
Okay, I'll start there. Deacon out.
Okay. Fishing pole. That's just the one. It's gotta be the right place. This is it. Which way?
Something behind the tree?
Inside here.
Where are you hiding, huh?
Can't see a damn thing. But there's a tooth there.
this way. So hard.
Men coming!
No.
Fight!
Abigail.
Thank God. I was...
No. She's dead, Ricky. I'm sorry.
God damn it.
I'm still looking for Gabby, and if she's out here, I'm gonna find her.
Okay. Thanks, Deke. Ricky out.
Gabby, it's okay. Hey. I'm not here to hurt you. Ricky sent me.
They killed my sister. They killed Abigail.
I know. I'm sorry. We just have to get you back to camp. Come on, with me.
No. I can make it myself. I can.
Okay, go.
That did it.
Fuel.
Ricky, I found her alive.
Deacon, thank God.
Look, she wouldn't come with me, so you gotta send someone who knows her, okay? She's on her way back to camp.
Okay. All right, okay.
What were you saying?
Okay. All right, okay. Ricky out.
I can fix this. Good.
Hey, did someone pick her up?
Hey, Dick, yeah, she's fine. A little traumatized, but I guess no more than anyone else.
Well, I guess we all know what it's like to lose someone.
Yeah, I guess we do.
O'Brien, I'm at one of your beacons, the one near Camp Creek. There's nothing here.
Hold on. Okay. A field op should be there any minute. You know the drill. O'Brien out.
Yeah, I know the drill. Try not to get my ass shot off while being your goddamn peeping Tom. St. John out. Yeah, so what was that all about? I mean, last time we talked, it sounded like you were pissing your hazmat suit.
It's nothing. I told you there are people above me who don't want us to know what's going on. I got too close, I almost got caught.
You know what? I don't give a shit. All I want from you is information on Sarah.
Whitaker, I've got someone working on it. It's gonna take time.
Do I?
This research group isn't part of my unit, so I can't track them after this op. I need you to...
Place a tracker on their chopper. Yeah, I get it. Oh, and you want me to spy on the guy wearing the white spacesuit. Yeah, anything else?
Yeah, try not to get your ass shot off. Your, comm was still open before. Don't think of it as, like, meeting Tom, more like opposition research. O'Brien out.
It doesn't matter what you call it, I'm doing that. I'm sure you're risking my neck.
I'm good.
Here they come. A bunch of tank soldiers marching in a row. Jesus.
Sure, we're locked down.
That's right. You always go on about your business. Don't mind me. Well, what it means is that some freaks get up in the morning, they shower, they get dressed, they put on their favorite gold watch, they kiss their wife goodbye, and then they head out the door for a fun day of meeting us and shitting themselves. Why the hell are these guys wasting their time with this shit? Hope you got all that, O'Brien. Okay, now just gotta get the hell out of here.
Well,
back to the base.
O'Brien, are you there? O'Brien!
Hold on. Yeah, I'm here.
I planted your tracking device and I got your data.